The song The Creature from Jekyll Island is based on, obviously, on G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. This lays out the case of the international banking scheme that's going on and that has hijacked the United States and pretty much every government in the world. So it's crucial to learn about the Federal Reserve System. Everybody needs to learn about this. You need to, when you learn, you do the research, you need to encourage other people to do it, because until people are aware of the Federal Reserve System and the fraud of fractional reserve banking, we have no chance of beating this entire scheme that's going on. So that's what the song The Creature from Jekyll Island is about. It's a hard charging, kind of a kick in the nuts and a bit of a warning to the globalists that are engineering this scheme. And hopefully it's going to make people think and make them do the research. Yeah, and I'm also here in LA to meet with G. Edward Griffin, which we're going to be doing later today, who is the author of The Creature from Jekyll Island, which really exposes the history of the Federal Reserve. And he wrote The Fearful Master, and he's written several really great books. That's going to be quite an honor for me, because it was that book that really opened my eyes to what is going on in our world and how all this stuff has come to be. How does it feel for you to have been researching this stuff for so many years and to see a lot of the things that you warned about even in your earlier writings coming on at what feels like light speed right now? I mean, how
does it feel? As you can well imagine, John, it's a mixed bag. I mean, it makes you feel good to think that you were able to predict certain things accurately that are coming online today. Think, well, gee, I did that right, you know. But that makes you feel terrible when you realize that it's so damaging to our society and to our country and to the future, the economy, all the things that, you know, we have taken for granted all these years. And all of a sudden, everything is coming unraveled, just as I had felt it might if we didn't reverse these trends. So it's a mixed bag. I feel that I'm vindicated in a way, and that I called the shots, but I have no pride in that when you think in terms of the dire results that are being produced for people. So it just makes me feel that time is running out to do something constructive. The whole thing won't be completely turned around for another generation or two. I probably won't see it myself. You probably will. And certainly the next generation will, in my view. And although that's discouraging in a way to think that we're not going to see this complete turnaround, at least I'm not in my lifetime, it's very encouraging to know that we're putting in motion today those forces that inevitably will win. I mean, our ideas, the concepts that we hold in common, the principles expressed in the Creed of Freedom, for example, they're spreading like wildfire now. People are understanding it and say, oh, I get it. Yes, this is what we need to do. This is the opposite of that is what the problem is today, and so forth. You see that going into place all over the world, and you know that in the next generation or the next one, there's no stopping that. It is truly an idea whose time has come.
Though I was devastated at first, when it really hit me, it was like it rocked me down to the core of my being, because I've always been such a patriot and a lover of the Founding Fathers and the American Revolution, that period of history, and all that, and to walk around my whole life thinking all that stuff was relevant still and that it mattered, and not knowing about the Federal Reserve System and what that really means and all of this stuff, it was like, I mean, it crushed me at first, but then I came alive like never before. Like, I'm invigorated, man. I mean, I've been walking around feeling this weight and feeling like something was wrong and never been able to pinpoint it, and not really, you know, you wonder why are things the way they are. Why is our society so sick, and why does the world have to be this way, and all of these things? And then that central piece of the puzzle is the Federal Reserve System, and knowing what that's really about and who the controllers are and the manipulators.
It's interesting, because I know you're in the music business, and generally I suppose you have great influence over a younger generation. The old codgers in my generation are too locked off already. They think that either they think everything continues to be the same as it used to be, or that they don't want to know anything about it because it's upsetting. It's hard to reach the old guys.
Yeah.
But the young guys or the young gals, they instinctively, I've seen, they know, as you said, there's something wrong. And the minute you show them what it is, they say, that's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Why didn't I see it before?
Right.
And now we've got a potential force there that could begin to make some change.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I really believe that if we can shine a light on this, then we can turn it around. I think every citizen of the world needs to read this book because, I mean, I really feel that way. Because if they do, and if they do the research and start really, I mean, it's not like this is just some made up stuff. This is real. And if they...
It's real history, yeah.
Yeah. And if they put the pieces of the puzzle together, they're going to say, that's the problem. These are the culprits, and this is who we need to focus on.
You're just the guy to do it. I'm so glad to have you on this team. It's a pleasure and an honor.
Thank you for all you've done, and I'm just going to keep carrying on the torch.